हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द डिस्कशन ऑन इंजीनियरिंग मैकेनिक्स। आई एम गायत्री मावळे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट इंजीनियरिंग साइंसेस डिपार्टमेंट, AISSMS, IOIT, पुणे 1। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट केबल, अजम्पशंस मेड इन एनालिसिस ऑफ केबल्स। वी विल ऑल्सो सी इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स इन द एनालिसिस ऑफ केबल्स एंड विल सॉल्व प्रैक्टिस प्रॉब्लम ऑन केबल्स। Cables are flexible members which find many engineering applications such as suspension bridges, aerial ropeways, aerial tramways, transmission lines, etc. Being flexible member, cables cannot resist any moment. It changes its shape as per the loads applied. The nature of force in cable is always tensile. According to their loading, cables are divided into two categories: cables supporting concentrated or point loads and cables supporting distributed loads. Here we have two cables. Cable ABCD on left hand side is having hinge support at point A and D, which are at same level. At B and C point, two vertically downward forces or each of 30 kN and 22.5 kN are acting at B and C point respectively. Vertical distance DB is called as sag of point B, and vertical distance DC is known as sag of point C. In second picture, for the cable ABCD, support at A and D point is fixed support. Though the support is fixed, but we know being flexible member, cables cannot resist bending moment. So the support reaction at A and D will be one vertical, one horizontal, like in case of pin or hinge joint. Assumptions made in analysis of cables. Cables offers no resistance to bending and adjusts its shape according to the applied loads. Weight of the cable is negligible compared with the loads applied on the cable. Therefore, in analysis of cables, we will neglect self-weight of cables. Any portion of cable between successive loads can be compared as a two-force member, and the internal forces at any point in the cable reduce to a force of tension directed along the cable. The cable and the supporting loads are in one vertical plane. The cross-section of cable is uniform. With all these assumptions, we can simplify analysis of cables. Steps to do analysis of cables are as follow. First of all, we have to draw FBD of whole cable. And then we have to consider equilibrium of whole cable by using three equations of equilibrium. Here you have to note that the reaction at the end points are equal to the tension in first and last part of the cable. To find tension in other parts of the cable, we have to draw FBD of points where loads are attached, and then for that FBD we have to use two equations of equilibrium. The part of cable which makes maximum angle with horizontal carries maximum tension, and for vertical loads only the first and last part of the cable can have maximum tension. So to find out maximum tension, we have to first find angle of first and last part with respect to horizontal. This will help us to know in which part of the cable maximum tension will occur. To take equilibrium of cable, we have to draw FBD of a joint in the cable. If inclined forces are acting in that FBD, we need to find out angles of inclined forces and then use equations of equilibrium to find unknowns. Important points in analysis of cable that we have to think on are, though the cable is supported by fixed supports at the ends, they behave as a pin support as cable is flexible member. So if at A point support for the cable is fixed, then also the reaction RA will be like hinge. This is suppose reaction at A point. And this is how reaction at B point will act. Say reaction RB. To maintain equilibrium at supports of the cable, support reactions are directed away from the support. The tension in cable near supports is same as that of the support reaction. It means tension in AC part of the cable will be equal to RA in magnitude but opposite in direction. And tension in BD part of the cable shown here will be equals to reaction at B point, equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. If all loads acting on the cable are vertical, then the horizontal component of tension in each part of the cable and also the horizontal component of support reactions are equal in magnitude. It means horizontal component of reaction at A, that is AX, X is acting somewhat like this suppose. This is equals to equal in magnitude with, say this is TAC cos theta. Further, it is equals to TCD cos theta B and is equals to TBD cos theta B is equals to BX, which is horizontal component of support reaction at B point. So all the horizontal reactions are equal in magnitude for vertical loadings. The part of cable which makes maximum angle with horizontal has maximum tension. Suppose angle made by AC part here is theta and angle made by DB part of the cable with horizontal is beta. And if theta is greater than beta, then obviously maximum tension will be in AC part of the cable. But if beta is greater than theta, then tension in BD part of the cable will be maximum. For vertical loads, only first and last part of the cable can have maximum tension. Let us solve one problem on cable analysis. Cable ABCD supports two point loads B and C as shown in figure. Determine the maximum tension in cable segment and sag of point B. So first step is to draw FBD of whole cable and then we will use equations of equilibrium. Angle of DC portion with respect to horizontal is tan inverse of 2 upon 0.5. So this gives angle theta here as 75.96 degree. Let us use first equation of equilibrium for this FBD, which is summation moment about A point equals to 0. Looking at the FBD, if we take moment about A point, moment because of RA will become 0. Moment because of 40 Newton force will be 40 into 1 meter and it is clockwise, so minus. Next is 60 Newton force and its distance is 4 meter, so it will cause clockwise moment of 60 into 4. Further, RD cos theta will pass through A point, so no need to take its moment. Moment of RD sine 75.96 will be anticlockwise and its distance is 4.5 meter from point A. If you solve this equation, it will give you value of RD as 64.14 Newton. Then use second equation of equilibrium, summation Fy equals to 0. Again, looking at the FBD, we can write RA sine theta plus RD, that is 64.14 sine 75.96 minus 60 minus 40. This is equals to 0. Solve this equation of vertical forces and you will get RA sine theta equals to 37.78. Then for same FBD, let us write down summation Fx equals to 0, third equation of equilibrium. So RA cos theta with minus sign plus RD cos 75.96 is equals to 0. This will give me RA cos theta A equals to 15.56 Newton. So now I have equation of RA sin theta and RA cos theta. Divide sin theta by cos theta, RA RA will get cancelled and we get tan theta is equals to 37.78 divided by 15.56. Take tan inverse of other side and you will get theta equals to 67.62 degrees. This is theta at A point. Now as theta at A point is less than theta at D point. Therefore, tension in CD part of the cable must be greater than tension in AB part of the cable. And tension in DC part of the cable, we have calculated it. It is equals to RD and is equals to 64.14 Newton. This is how we can calculate tension in CD part of the cable, that is maximum tension. One more thing is asked as unknown in this problem, which is sag at B point, that is YB. Once we know angle theta A, then I can write down tan of that angle is equals to vertical distance YB divided by horizontal distance 1 meter. This gives me YB equals to 2.43 meter. In this discussion, we have seen what is cable, what are assumptions made in analysis of cables, important points in the analysis of cables, and then we have solved one practice problem on cable. This is one homework problem for you. Two loads are suspended as shown in figure below of cable ABCD. Knowing that vertical distance DC is 0.75 meter and vertical distance DB is 1.125 meter, determine the component of reaction at A, maximum tension in the cable. Answers are given for your reference. You try a detailed solution and match your answers with the given. You can use textbook and reference books for further practice. Thank you.